So when you intonate this way, you know, silently, you know, you're not repeating the note, but you feel it inside. That's just, that feels amazing. When you don't fully understand the musical score, your playing will be filled with heaviness, boredom, and unnecessary tension while trying to avoid that boredom. And trust me, I know what I'm talking about because honestly, I played this piece when I was 15. I think my teachers tortured me with this theme for over 2 years. And I remember eventually I was just full of tension, trying to you know, copy what my teachers would tell me because my playing was not expressive and convincing enough. So yeah, guys. So you have to have, you know, a clear idea of your interpretation, a clear idea of every little thing that is written in the score. Tone production, harmony, articulation, dynamics, voicing, musical speech, of course, phrasing length and contour, musical form, the development of the story, time, and basically rubatos at the end that you would add based on all the above things that you would have in your head. So then your playing will be like a natural flow, a beautiful simplicity, full of air, breathing, light. So if you follow all your imagination in your mind, you will also have your own very, well, original, I would say, interpretation, and you, in a new side of music that you can show the audience. Anyways, so today I'm going to focus only on the most important and interesting parts, which are time notes, articulation, hairpins, and phrasing, and I hope that will ease your playing. So time notes could be very, very interesting and helpful here. There are two things that I would like to stress here. When you have a time note, it's basically two notes, right? So make sure that when you imagine that note, first of all, you imagine it long enough in your imagination. And when you're going to imagine it in harmonies, make sure that you change the color of the second tied note when you imagine. So this is the harmony of the first note, and that is the harmony of the second note. So if I would sing, for example, what I imagine, it would sound this way. So you can feel through my voice, it's different. So you will intonate it also differently when you're gonna play. And by the way, this note that comes right after the tied note, in this case, will be always soft enough. So it will always nicely resolve. And the same basically everywhere. And on the second page, also F minor. Expressiveness to your playing. And the second thing to say is when, oh, by the way, since we're talking about the harmonies on tied notes, make sure that when you start your theme, you know exactly in which harmony those three notes are. So we're in C major, and basically you can do this either in C major and then F minor, which I did. So in this case, this C would be a little bit louder because it's a kind of dominant to resolving F minor, and this B natural would be a little bit softer. But it's basically like this. And two sighs, you know, and then from that a theme is born. Quite helpful to know that it's not just three notes that you're supposed to, you know, play soft. Okay, anyways, so the second step is feeling musical speech. So this is what musical speech is all about. Ability to feel a difference in singing different intervals will let us pre-feel through intonation the distance of every interval much more accurately. That helps mind and hands to faster prepare to the intervals. As I have said before many times, if we can't feel fast while playing, we're not ready to play fast. Feel the difference in sound while singing with intonation these intervals. So when you feel musical speech in this unison, because it's basically there is some interval. So let's say you sing these two notes to the right, and you feel kind of intonation. So you still feel, you know, resistance and glissando, and you would intonate it with the motion of unison. So. Second again. So when you intonate this way, you know, silently, you know, you're not repeating the note, but you feel it inside. Oh, that's just, that feels amazing. When you play, everything starts making so much sense right away. And the same here. So these two things, feeling harmonies, feeling changes of harmonies on the same note, and internally intonating two notes with musical speech in unison is the key to success of playing these side notes. Make sure you have the very first edition of this piece to see the authenticity of all the articulations. You know, you will be surprised how little Chopin actually wrote in the score. Anyway, so the accent on the very first note of the theme is written by Chopin. This one. So, but what it actually says is that this note has to be simply a bit more expressive and prominent, nothing more than that. So when you reach this note as an ascending six, with musical speech and intonation, let's say you come here, and then you go, this is how you make it more intense. So, so if you're gonna try to make accent, I remember I was told to make an accent when I was 15, which always turned out to be too harsh, so now I know why. It's just a reminder that this note has to have more expressiveness.